It's a joy here to be at Columbia Rural Baptist Church. We do a lot of canvassing for your church. We have a ministry called the Heart Ministry. We started this process about 2001. A little snapshot of my background. Back when I was 19 years old, I was in the Vietnam War area. I was on the 67th Fleet. And my first ship on the Shenandoah, my fellow sailor, his name is John Crady, shared the gospel with me. And it was in the gyrocompass room of the USS Shenandoah, and about an hour later, I trusted Christ as my Savior. And basically, after the Navy, I was a troubleshooter for Ohio Bell for 16 years, and in that process, I went to the Bible Institute, met Diana, we got married, we've been married for 43 years, and then I went on staff, I was through the Bible Institute and finishing it up. In the beginning of 1985 at Cleveland Baptist, I was the outreach director there for a period of 17 years, and it gave me an opportunity, and Diana as well, to be involved in just about every aspect of outreach you could think of. I had my office open 5 days a week for outreach visitation. We had the Spanish class, even though I'm German background, don't ask me how that came about, but we ended up averaging around 38 in the Spanish class up there, so we praise the Lord for that. Then I oversaw the discipleship class on Wednesday, oversaw 13 nursing homes. Diana had a ladies' Bible study on Friday, and she was engaged in a lot of our discipleship and many other opportunities we had. So around 2000, God put in our heart to stir our heart that maybe we can go alongside small independent Baptist churches and perhaps be a blessing. We didn't know exactly what we were going to do, but as it just morphed into just a scenario where we are able to work in seven counties in this region. Last year we worked down in Alabama, the year before in Florida, during the wintertime. We were able to, down by Birmingham, we were actually in completed eight developments, and seven visitors came in. They're very, very kind down there, and it was just a wonderful place to work. And we like to work in the inner city of Cleveland. The past 2 years, we go on a two-year cycle, and we're trying to do between 20 and 25,000 contacts in that two-year cycle. In this last two-year cycle, we're great in Rodeos, which is about West 200th down to East 60th and Harvard, helping churches in Garfield Heights and Bedford, and also over there in Maple Heights as well. We put together blitzes. We started this blitzes about 2002. What we do is we help smaller churches. One of our bigger blitzes, we have 15 churches come together and a church running 25. And we had 85 folks out visiting for them. And that's an encouragement to these smaller churches to have. We made about 1,600 contacts that day. But one thing we did is that over the years, we started putting together Bible studies that turned into courses. Starting in 1997, Pastor Folger asked me to put together a finance management program for the church. The only qualification was that I was the only one out of debt on the staff, and I thought, well, that was a pretty poor qualification, but nevertheless, it worked out fine. We did a lot of research. Back in the day, it was Larry Burkett, like we have these other guys today, but it worked out good. We had put 20 pages together. It helped a lot of folks get out of debt and so forth. Then one by one, we started to put together courses, and basically, we now have 68 free Bible courses, most of them 8 lessons online, free of charge. And by God's grace, we're in over 100 countries now. A lot of poor countries of the world use our Bible studies. We get input all the time about that. You're part of that. So as we're part of Columbia Road Baptist Church in the outreach in here, you also have over 100 churches, 100 countries that are using our material all over the world. Indonesia recently, United Kingdom, Australia, the Philippines, China, all over the place, and it's really interesting. Jails use it from Michigan down to Florida, and just wonderful to see some friendly faces here. Miriam helped us when we got the ministry started in 1991. She took care of our music department. We had a wonderful music department down in our Spanish class, and we enjoyed it so very much, and got to know her family and her dear husband. Her daughter was only, when we visited her daughter, she was just a baby, and I guess that was about 20 years ago or so. So we won't say how long ago that was, but it was a long time ago. And basically, Christina went from the crib. And we were young, and now we're not young, right? That's right. So we just had Jimmy and Brenda Lowe, we just finished doing his neighborhood. The old neighborhood, we're between 110th and 117th. I think they lived around 116th. worked their streets. We work about 40 neighborhoods a year, about 80 neighborhoods every 2 years, and we ask for divine appointments on Monday. And a week ago Monday, I was working in the Monday morning and afternoon, witnessed to 17 folks, multicultural, black and Spanish, very receptive folks there in the inner city. And when we just give them the gospel, we have a John and Romans that we have back there you can pick up, and a Bible study that leads people to Christ. And we'll give you some illustrations as we go through our little sheet here. Basically, we have all these free things back there. Take what you want, but our Bible, our website is kjvhearthelps.com, kjvhearthelps.com. And basically, we have the our prayer card, The Beauty and the Beast, and you can figure out, you know, at least we have Donna's cello music on there as well. And part of this curriculum is we have the whole New Testament online. We have Psalms and Proverbs. We put together Old Testament character studies in the which entails 40 studies. We have a scripture memory program. Diana put together a Virtuous Woman program here, which the church used in their Bible Institute here many years ago. As a matter of fact, Cindy Yoger taught that here. And so we have biblical integrity as well, Bible doctrines, attributes of the godly, just all kinds of wonderful things on there for you, all free of charge. Diana, I learned to delegate, Brother Steve. Diana can type 94 words a minute without making an error. I can type 11 words a minute making 94 errors. So we let her do the typing, and she's an outstanding speller as well. So this really has helped us through this process, and God has met the needs there as well. Let us go, we'll start here. Yeah, this sheet here will not take as long as you may think here. I work these sheets and I do not waste time, at least I do not try. But the Bible teaches, it says that we should have a teachable spirit. A wise man will hear and will increase knowledge. A man will attain unto a wise counsel. And first, on Proverbs 1:5. And Proverbs 4:23, keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it issues of life. And so, as we look at these things, we're going to look at the word B-E, and it's mentioned 5,500 times in the Bible. Now, we're not going to cover all those today. We'll cover some today that when I was in the Navy, join the Navy and see the world. Well, I saw 20 countries, so that was nice, you know, as I was in the Navy. I thought, I'm not going to take my leave in Cleveland. I told my leave in the Philippines and China and Hong Kong there at the time when it was open. I took it in Salzburg, Austria, and Germany, and Italy, and all these various places, Hawaii, and I enjoyed all that. But we want to go into an area here in Ephesians chapter 6 that we're going to read together these four verses out loud, and then we'll have prayer, and then we'll mention some other things about the ministry. But we praise the Lord for you all supporting us, I think since 2003, maybe 2002. Basically, I'm using this tool today. We've had our share of issues. Diana started having heart problems back 20 years ago, where her heart was only functioning at 15% of her heart. And now it's up to 40%, but she can function, you know, and she's able to walk 2 miles a day now, and she goes canvassing. The doctor asked her, her last appointment, can you walk around the block? She said, well, I can walk 2 miles. She said, we'll see you next year. Well, that's a good sign, you know. And I had atrial fib. As a matter of fact, that's why I'm sitting right now. I can walk fine, but if I stand for long periods of time in the evening, it affects me, and you don't want me passing out in front of you here, so we'll just go ahead and sit here. Being 6'3" helps. I can still look like I'm 5'10" anyway here. So Ephesians 6 here. This book of Ephesians is very interesting on relationships. Also, the word in is mentioned in every sentence from Ephesians 1 to Ephesians 2:4, although Paul has some very, very long sentences, but we're going to look at the word be here and how it concerns us here. So we'll start in Ephesians chapter 6 in verse number 10. Let's read aloud together. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. So you see that idea, be strong in the Lord, be able to stand. And so we're going to look at this idea, be it all you can, be all ye can be for Jesus Christ. Father, we're thankful that we have a great and wonderful God that can help us in our weaknesses and make them strengths, oh God. We know, Lord, that some of us are getting older now, that we can have the presence of God, start a fervent prayer life, send out cards, visit the elderly, do many things, go into nursing homes, make ourselves available to the needs of others, Lord. All of us need to be missionaries where we're at, whether it be in our workplace, in our neighborhood, in our home life, wherever it might be, in the marketplace. Help us, Lord, to have a burden for the souls about us. Hell is real, and it's an awful place, and we don't want anyone to go there. And you're not willing that any should perish. So as we go through this, Lord, help us to garner what we need in this. There's just so many aspects. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm a seven sport guy. I love sports. I still play about five sports, but my key sport growing up was golf. And I became a good golfer. I was a caddy, and at 16 years old, Valley Forge opened up, Valley Forge High in Parma, and these guys were trying out for the golf team, and they already had a year of golf there, and the fourth spot was open, but I had to beat 42 other guys to get that fourth spot. And I weigh a 205 right now, but back then I weighed 144 and still was 6'3", so you can imagine what I looked like. You know, like, this is not a real prospect for on the golf team. But I learned the game at an early age, starting at 8 years old. I beat out those other 42 guys, you know. And basically, I learned diligence, I learned discipline, how to be versatile on that golf course or whatever it is, learned many shots. And in the Christian realm here, God wants us to be the best we can be. And we're going to look at some of these areas in which we can get strong. This is number one here, Psalm 18:3. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies. And we just talked about being strong in the Lord, and our main enemy is the devil, you know, but he is trying to put a dump truck full of stuff in our mind and our heart to destroy each and every one of us. And we need to be in the Word and study it, be students of the Word of God. I'd like you to turn over to 2 Timothy. This is more or less the outline. I'm not going to preach this at all, but the idea starts with S's here, the idea of being a good soldier for Jesus Christ, and just going from there. It says in 2 Timothy 2, in verse number 3, thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No man that warreth entangle himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier. There is an identity. We have an identity with the Lord Jesus Christ. We ought not to be ashamed of him. We go out in the field there. I have a identity card there. I have a Navy hat on. I reintroduce myself sometimes from Columbia Road. I'm Brian Starr, representing Columbia Road Baptist Church. This is a tract that shows you how you can know for sure you can go to heaven by trusting Jesus Christ as your Savior and having your sins forgiven, and starting with something like that. But we have an identity in Christ. We're soldiers of the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't get entangled with the things of this world. I love to do research, and I'm at that age where I was looking up the sleep doctor guy. He said, whatever you do, don't watch the news before you go to sleep. That's not really a good idea, you know. It's just going to mess up your mind. You're just going to have a bad night's sleep or whatever it is. And just keep our focus on the Lord Jesus Christ. Set your affection on things above. I have harp hymns, cello hymns. When I go visiting, I have these apps, and there'll be a cello and a piano in the background. And people are wondering, where is this harp music coming from? You know, I'm out there visiting, and they hear it in the background. Calms my spirit, and it sort of eases their mind as well. But the idea here is we are soldiers of Christ. We're also students of the Word of God. Look in verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. We ought to be diving into the Word of God. We ought to be studying it, memorizing, meditating on it, sharing it with other people, hearing it, and so forth. Diana has memorized 8 books of the Bible. She's also memorized Psalm 119. She's memorized the Beatitudes. When about 40-some years ago, when I was Troubleshooter Ohio Bell. I took the time to memorize four scriptures a day for a year, about 1,400 scriptures, that have worked in my heart and life to help me through the toughest times and also in the outreach as we have it here. And then we have in Psalm 19:14, this is outstanding, not only be praised, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. It starts in our mind and in our mouth, in our meditation, and we have a mission. And basically, I want to give you a side script, a verse you can put down, Psalm 141:3. Set a watch, O Lord, before my mouth. Keep the door of my lips. Well, if we just do that, it'd be a better world, amen? Just control our tongue. I'm going to give you an acronym on THINK. You've heard THINK before you speak, right? THINK. T, say things that are true. Say things that are true. H, say things that are helpful. Helpful. I, say things that are inspiring to that person. N, say things that are needful. And then K, what do you think? Say things that are kind. You know, a person can say, hey, Brother Starr, you have a big nose. Well, that's true. But it's not necessarily helpful or inspiring or needful or kind. You know, so a lot of those things we have to weigh in there. And so basically, those are good things to remember as we go through life. Okay, Psalm 21:3. Be thou exalted, Lord, in thine own strength, so will we sing and praise thy power. As Brother Steve was saying, if you're going through depression or discouragement, to have the songs of God, I listen to, I would say, 6 hours of Christian music. I play a guitar and I have a harmonica, Diane plays a cello. But just to have that music going, it will relieve depression right away. Also, Psalms 23 through Psalms 40 are great psalms that help us to overcome discouragement in our life. Psalms 23 through Psalms 40 will help us as well. Psalm 34, as a matter of fact, in that group, 1 through 4, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. O magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. You know, there is a diligent seeking. We live in a state of America. Dan Wolven, a good friend of mine, he helped mentor pastor here, asked me a while back, what is the problems in our local church? I said, the same problems they had back in the Laodicean church. They either were lukewarm or cold. Like the Ephesian church, they lost their first love. Or like the Corinth church, they have become carnal. And that can happen to all of us. We can put on a good face in church, but how are we from Monday through Saturday? We need to be in the Word of God, applying it, being obeying as well, having a humble spirit as we see here, honoring the Lord in our life, being honest before God. The Bible says, search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts, and see if there be wicked, any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. Psalm 139, 23 and 24. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. When I go out in the inner city, I don't want to be dirty, one little bit. I want to be clean as can be. And I'm glad we can have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin. Then Psalm 27:14, this is a great one. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. 2 Timothy 1:7, basically says, God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. And we systematically try to do at least 3 times a day golden canvassing. We had a period where we went 30 straight days in the last 2 years. And another day, time, 20 straight days. But nonetheless, we had a good February. It was a really good February. I think we did 1,700 households in February, and I think 5,000 total in the first 4 months. But you know, I feel good. Like the other day, I witnessed the 7 folks on finishing up this area where Jimmy and Brenda used to live on West 111th and West 112th. And basically, witnessed the 7 folks, Spanish folks, black folks, a white fellow, and they took the material, you know. We have a John and Romans and Bible study, you have tracts back there. You know, everyone thought, I'm going to give out an average of one tract a day, one tract a day. It might not be every day, but one tract a day. And everyone in this room gave out one tract a day. Can you imagine what a difference would make, you know? We try to do more than that. Our goal is 300 tracts a week. We are older, but we're able to still walk and talk and give out the simple gospel, and we all have an opportunity to be a missionary where we're at. Psalm 46 says in verse 10, number 5, "Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. Be still and know that I am God." Often we get caught up quickly in the things of routine, and I think the best routine is to start the day with the Lord. You might wash your face or take a shower, but it says in Psalm 5:3, "My voice shalt thou hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee and will look up." And then Mary, it says about Mary, she had a sister called Mary, which sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. Martha was encumbered with a lot of work and so forth, but put first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and you won't regret it. There was a lady that we knew from Faith Community Baptist Church that gave a testimony that her workplace was just bickering and fighting and quarreling, gossiping, and she just started getting up 20 minutes early praying for her workplace. In a short period of time, that whole spirit changed. And so God can do that, you know, just focus on those kind of things. And then as we look at this, it sounds very, very difficult, but it says in Matthew 5:48, "Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect." Our Lord is able to perfect that which is lacking in us. Paul says, "I can do all things through Christ which strengtheneth me." And he can help us to knock off those rough edges as he shows us by his Spirit where our downfalls are, our uprisings are, and to be the kind of Christian we can be. Be all you can be for Jesus Christ. Matthew 10:16, "Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves." I don't know about you, but I like KFC chicken. It's one of the last places that's pretty cheap, you know. And we can get chicken and mashed potatoes and coleslaw and a drink and bread and all that. But KFC is an interesting acronym to me. I'm at that age where I need to use acronyms and use alliteration, even to do my shopping list, just to keep things in mind. But K, again, being kind when we go out there. F, being friendly. And then C, being compassionate and being courteous to people and being cheerful as well. We go in these areas and there's a lot of glumness, but we can bring a spirit of cheer, a spirit of kindness, and a spirit of friendliness to them. And then Matthew 10:43, 44, and 45, 8, 9, and 10, they all go together. The Lord is talking here, our Lord Jesus. But so shall it not be among you, but whosoever will be great among you shall be your minister, and whosoever of you will be chiefest shall be servant of all. For even the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and to give his life a ransom for many. We have 29 zip codes we work with across Northeast Ohio. We have teams in Medina to help us out, and teams from various churches. Sandy Williams is part of our heart team. She was out with Diana. They had six calls lined up, and we have lost our son my father-in-law with a matter of 7 months. So we know the grief there. Sandy lost her daughter, lost her husband in a short period of time as well. So there were a couple of ladies that lost one, Nancy Sorenda. She had lost her daughter suddenly about a month ago, Patty. And so we tried to visit her, but she wasn't available. But then Christine, one of our dear friends, she's 83 years old, she took care of her granddaughter since she was a young person. Her granddaughter died when she was 45 just a month ago. And she was an invalid. And then she took care of her daughter, and her daughter died on May 27th. So she lost her daughter, she lost her granddaughter within the last year. And they understand. They understand the pain you lose when, it's sort of natural to lose maybe your husband or wife and maybe your father and mother, but to lose a child or lose a grandchild, they understand. We have a God of all comfort who comforts in all our troubles that we can comfort others in their need as well. And so we have a list of folks of over 60 families in which we either send cards or visit them or call them or whatever it is. And then we canvass their neighborhoods. They can stay and pray. Brother Kinder just passed away. We just finished an area since the beginning of the year, between West 105th all the way down to East 60th, door by door, systematically. But they can stay and pray while we canvass for them. And then we go on down to number 11. This is critical, and there may be in a crowd this size someone that falls in this category that needs this. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. It's not by osmosis. It's not because your mom and dad got saved. It's not by being religious. It's not by good works. It's not beyond being a part of a church. I was sharing with a lady, Linda, over in that region there the other day, and prayer with her, and she was a religious lady. I said, let me share one scripture with you. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me. And I had the track there, and we show folks this. We have an opportunity to do discipleship. Pastor Barda down the street here at Faith Baptist Temple had a lady get saved, and that was part of the Young and Hearts group. Her aide came. She was 20 years old, black lady, and she trusted Christ. Diana started discipling her. Recently, her sister started joining in. Diana led her to Christ, and they both got baptized 3 weeks ago. And it makes a difference to bring it to the table, show them how to be born again. Show them we are not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to His mercy, He saved us. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But God commendeth His love towards us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. If we confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in our heart that God hath raised Him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. It's simple, but it's not easy. You share that with people, they have their pride and they have their religion, and they just don't think it could be that simple. But it is that simple when we repent and trust Christ as our Savior. Then we look at number 12, Romans 12:2. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. And we want this church and all our local churches here to keep going forward. You know, compromise and complacency will kill the church. To compromise the Word of God, compromise the music, compromise the holiness. We have the Holy Bible. We have the Holy Spirit. We have a most holy faith. God wants us to be a holy people, to be blameless before the world. Not perfect, but when they look at us, they're not going to see any sin that they can point their fingers at. And then the idea of being faithful. 1 Corinthians 4:2. Moreover, it is required in stewards that a man be found faithful. 2 Corinthians 4:1 says, Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not. So be faithful to the things of God. 1 Corinthians 15:58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Ephesians 2:10 says, For we are His workmanship in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in Him. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Then we move on. Philippians 2:2, Fulfill ye my joy that you be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord, of one mind. Psalm 33:1, Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Philippians 2:5, Let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. And we see a description of the Lord as a humble, obedient servant. Number 17, Ephesians 4:32, And be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. See, there's a lot of room for improvement for all of us, isn't there, as we look at this. And then number 18, Ephesians 5:1, Be ye therefore followers of God as dear children. It all starts with us. It says, If my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked way, then I'll hear from heaven, heal their land and forgive their sin. The problem with America is us. It's not Republicans, it's not the Democrats, it's us, that we're not reaching people as we should be. We need to help depopulate hell and see people come to know the Lord Jesus. Get away from our apathy, get in a position where we can reach people for our Lord Jesus Christ. And then as we get into the area of Thanksgiving, 19, Colossians 3:15. Let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also you are called in one body, and be thankful. It says in Colossians 4:2, every chapter deals with thanksgiving in Colossians. It says, continue in prayer and watching the same with thanksgiving. Just a continuance in prayer. 1 Thessalonians 5:13 and 14, we'll group them together. To esteem them very highly in love for the work's sake, and be at peace among yourself. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient toward all men. About the peace aspect, the Bible says in Romans 12:18, if it be possible, as much as lieth in you, live peaceably with all men. Matthew 5:9 says, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. James 1:22, but be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. The Bible says, he that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. James 4:17. Number 23, 1 Peter 1:5. Because as is written, hath called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation. Because it is written, be ye holy, for I am holy. I mentioned that before. Number 24, 1 Peter 3:8. Finally, be ye of one mind, have compassion one of another, love as brethren, be pitiful, be courtesy, be full of, courteous, be full of pity. The Lord was, after the days of Job was going through all that trouble, at the end of it all, the Lord was very pitiful and merciful to him. Then 25, 1 Peter 3:15. But sanctify the Lord God in your hearts, and be ready always to give an answer to every man that asketh you a reason of the hope that is in you with meekness and fear. On Monday, I asked God to give me divine appointments through the week. Think about, you know, folks that you need the Lord, or open up opportunities that God can use. I talked to a man that just got out of prison after 16 years. I didn't know what I didn't ask what he did, but his name was Stephen, and he had a friend. I shared the gospel with him. He says, I need to change my life, and so pray for Stephen and his friend. Then our memorization verse, Philippians 4:11. Not that I speak in respect of want, for I have learned in whatsoever state I am, therewith to be content. Hebrews 13:5 says, let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as you have, for he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. Psalm 68:19, blessed be the Lord, who daily loadeth us with benefits, even the God of our salvation. Father, we're thankful for the Word of God. Help us to be what we need to be as we ourselves, if we're diligent, to look over this and see where we can make our weaknesses strengths. Lord, we, in the area of thanksgiving and being content, Lord, and being faithful to the things of God, even when we're going through trials, the Bible says, thinking not strange concerning the fiery trial, which is to try you as though some strange thing happened to you, but rejoice that you're partakers of Christ's suffering, that when his glory shall be revealed, you should be glad with exceeding joy. We're going to be with the Lord before we know it. Help us to be the soul winners, the disciplers, the planters of seed all around, Lord. Help us to have a vision as we come into this good season, good weather. Help us to have a mission where we are, to bloom where we're at, Lord, to be what we need to be for our Lord Jesus Christ. In your precious name we pray, amen. Brother Steve?
And obviously, in some ways, it feels like a water hose of Bible truth and principle coming at us tonight. But if you're like me, even though we had 25 plus Bible verses that came our way tonight, I'm certain one or two or three of them in particular, the Holy Spirit nudged you about and said, this is something that you need. And so I would challenge you this evening as we glance at this sheet of paper again, say, Lord, what are you challenging me to do with what I heard here this evening? Be ye thankful. We live in a world that's just not thankful anymore. And how easy it is for us at times to think about all the challenges and difficulties and struggles that we have and forget to be thankful. The Bible says the last days, one of the things that defines just how bad things have gotten in our world is that men will no longer be thankful. As believers, we should be thankful in all things. We're commanded in the Word of God in numerous places to be thankful. And so maybe that's it. And say, Lord, with your help, I need to be more thankful. I want to be all that you would want me to be for Jesus Christ. So, Lord, help me to do that. Psalm 19:14, you've been around here long enough, you know that's one of my favorite verses. It's a verse I need every single day of my life because I want the words that I say and the things that I speak to be acceptable or pleasing to the Lord. And maybe you've struggled with that, having impure thoughts towards someone or being angry at someone and just wanting to let them have it with both barrels. But then you're reminded to let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. And here's how we can do that. My strength and my Redeemer. Can't do this on our own. None of these things we can do on our own. But we can be pleasing to the Lord with what we say and what we think because he is our strength. Again, that was Ephesians 6:10. Be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. And he is our Redeemer. He has purchased us. He owns us. And he has changed us. And we can live the Christian life. And so maybe there's others. Be kind to all men. Ephesians 4:32 we looked at, and be ye kind, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God who for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. And so whatever it is tonight, whatever area that maybe you sense the nudging of the Holy Spirit, maybe putting his finger on something that says you need this, or maybe the way he works in my life often is you're going to need this. You're going to need this later tonight. You're going to need this tomorrow or next week. And so grab a hold of it. And what I have found that absolutely when he does that, he is 100% right. Oftentimes I need it for myself, for whatever situation I find myself in, maybe the very next day, or I need it for someone else that is really struggling and needs to be reminded that the Lord is there. He will never leave us nor forsake us, or that some promise that we can point them to. And so again, that's how the Holy Spirit works. So there's a lot on here. And I would say, as we pray, before we sing and have our time of invitation, say, Lord, show me what it is you want to do in my life. What area of my life that you want to change so that I can be all I can be for Jesus Christ. None of us have arrived yet. I hold Brother Brian and Sister Dinah in very high esteem. They are hard workers. They are disciplined. They are go-getters. They don't let anything slow them down. And if there is a walking Bible, we heard it tonight, right? But they're not yet like Christ. They have growing to do themselves, changing to do themselves, and so do we. And so embrace that idea that my Christian life will always be one of growth and one of moving forward and one of saying, Lord, you're right. I shouldn't have thought that. I shouldn't have said that. I shouldn't have done that or went there or I missed an opportunity that you set up, a divine appointment, and I just ignored it. And so, Lord, I don't want to be that person. I want to be your man, your woman, your child. And so, Lord, help me to do that. Help me to stand by faith on these amazing principles. So let me ask you, if you're able, let's stand. We're going to have a word of prayer. Altar is open. Brother Jim will come and lead us in an invitation hymn. If you need to do business with the Lord, and just acknowledge, say, yes, Lord, you are right. Thank you for reminding me yet once again of how you want to work in my life and how you will work in my life when I'm submitted and surrendered to you. Father, thank you for your faithful servants. Thank you for their willingness to always invest in others, to help others, to point others to you as the solution to all of their problems. And so, Lord, help us to learn from their example. Help us to be motivated by their example. Help us endeavor to hide your word in our heart that we may not sin against you. And not only that, Lord, that we may be able to share its power and its truth and its strength with others that so desperately need it, ourselves included. And so, Lord, I'm convinced here tonight, as we've heard so much scripture, that every one of us here, in some way, because it's how the Holy Spirit works, has shown us things in our lives that you want to change. And may we simply be obedient to the leadership of the Holy Spirit in our lives and say, yes, Lord, I will do what it is that you want me to do. I will cast off, put off, and put on, and I will live this, Lord, with your strength and your power, because you are my Redeemer. And so, Lord, bless our time of invitation, we pray. May you be glorified, may we be helped through it. We ask these things in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Go, Jim.